when you're ready.
Great second half, Greg. Left an awful lot to do.
Well, I think we kept from the start of the game, we left off where we left off on Saturday. You know, when you're 2-0 down after 6 minutes through inept defending, you know, it's not as though the lad who scored both goals has done a trick or done a good run. He's just got in behind us from a ball just over the top, you know. So we've come in, you know, after 6 minutes, 2-0 down. And we didn't get to grips at all with the game at all, never mind how they were playing, and for about half an hour. And we started getting back into it, and then Jimmy had that free kick where the keeper's made a really good save. And then, of course, Danny's missed his penalty. You know, so I'm thinking to myself, you know, 2-1. You know, and we're back in it, and, you know, Carl gets us the goal just before half-time. And I felt we deserved that. Having said that, they had another couple of chances where, you know, he's hit the post and gone through. But I felt at half-time that we probably deserved to come in 3-2 down with the penalty miss. Second half, we changed the formation, went 3-5-2. And for 45 minutes, we've absolutely battered Rushall Olympic this afternoon at the second half. Clear to see. We've been hammering on that door for 45 minutes. It was an accumulation of probably poor finishing and really good goalkeeping. And that's what he's there to do. Adam's had to do nothing second half. He's been a spectator, but over the balance of the game, we've deserved more than what we've got tonight here, Gary.
Yeah, I think the difficulty, again, as you said, it was such a slow start. And so to find yourself 2-0 after 6 minutes. And a Beng was really a thorn in our side, particularly first half, because every time he seemed to, you know, we seemed to be concentrating on Walker for a while, and a Beng was just finding space.
Well, we always thought Obeng's got that pace. We felt that if Walker was just tightly marked, he wouldn't be in the game. That proved right. He did nothing all afternoon. But when you give somebody 2-goal start at any level of football, you've got a mountain to climb, irrespective of home. You can't play football on this. You know, nobody can play football this. You can get any level of football player. You cannot play football on this pitch. And I hope the club sort it out next year, because this isn't good enough. And okay, the fans are getting, you know, better value for money. That's great. But at the end of the day, from a manager's point of view, I won't be playing on a better service than that. But I ain't going to blame the pitch. Both teams have had to play on it. But unfortunately, there's no free-flowing football at Marsden Road at the moment. And, you know, that's going to change next year.
Did you find it, particularly second half, because we're attacking on the better end of the pitch, did the players actually come back and say it did make such a difference?
It is easy to attack down this side. That proved on Saturday. You know, we scored two, Fickley scored two, and all the goals of Islam scored down here again today. But it's like everything, you know, the defending, we didn't clear his headers, we didn't turn them. It was just things again where on pitches like this you've got to do solid, and we didn't do it first half. Second half we did. You know, I think Obeng went up through twice, which Adam saved quite comfortably. Apart from that, Rushall have just scrapped and cleared the lines and rode their luck second half, Gary. And on another night, we could have easily come off this game with 3 points.
We get to North Ferriby Saturday, which is going to be it was always going to be a difficult game. And they're on the back of six straight wins, flying high at the top. We know what they're like. They're very organised. They're a difficult side to play against. You know, Rangers have got to defend significantly better against North Ferriby, otherwise been much the same story.
North Ferriby top of the league for a reason, Gary. They don't make mistakes. And you get anything near their box, it's cleared. And if you don't clear your line at the other end, they're going to score. And that's why they are where they are. If you're top of the league, you're doing things right, week in, week out. That's where we strive to be next year. But we've got a long way to go. You know, on this pitch, we should know now, after playing two lots of 45 minutes in the space of a couple of days, we should know how to win games on this football pitch now. And today, again, I think my parting words were to you last Saturday was, when you only turn up for 45 minutes, you're not going to win a game. And unfortunately, we've lost one today. But on another day, if we'd had a little bit more luck, we could have easily got 3 points. And I think they know that as well. But at the end of the day, we've picked nothing up for our effort second half.
Cool. Cheers, Greg.
Pleasure.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, mate.